Okay, today we are talking about my bow vise. When I was outfitting this shop here, I wanted something that I could adjust in a number of different directions. I wanted something that was removable so that when I wasn't using it, I could still use this space and not have to worry about going over top or around a vise. I wanted something that was versatile but also not super expensive. And if you look in the archery market right now, there's a couple of leaders in the industry, one being the Baker Vise, which I absolutely loved. I was looking at, I was going to pull the trigger on, but there's a couple of things that stopped me from doing that. One was they're out of stock, which is not their fault. That's the power of demand. But also, therefore, about $350 to $450 for a Canadian to buy one. I think they range anywhere from 250 to 300 US. So you add on all the other things that we got to pay for in exchange and getting it up here, and it would have been expensive. And for something that I don't see myself using this more than a handful of times a year, it was hard for me to justify that type of expense. So the only other option was to get something that fixed onto the table that only held the bow by the limb and had no sort of movement or ability to flip things around. And that's when I found this one. This is a vise that is completely 360-degree movable. It will attach anywhere on the bow, the handle, the limb, the riser, you name it. It can be the base, obviously, will attach to the table with these four screws that it comes with, but you can very easily, with a turn of the knob, take it and put it away when you're not using it, which is also very cool for me, especially when I use this table for a variety of things. It's made by a company called Ameyegs. I think I've probably butchered that name. Sold by a manufacturer called ZD Outdoor. They are an Asian company. They create a number of different outdoor gear that is sold overseas. I haven't used anything like this before. I'm not necessarily recommending this yet because I haven't put it through the paces, but I'm just showing you what it is, what it does, and how it can be used. It is an option. If you're looking for a middle of the road, you don't want the $60 one that just holds your bow. You want to actually be able to do things with it and have some ability to move your bow around into various positions. That's important. So again, I don't know how long this is going to last, but I'm hoping it does. It is an all metal construction. The only plastic on it are these handles here. So my only concern would be over time the torquing of the handles on and off. I don't know how well that's going to last, but I don't know. It could be fantastic and last for a long time. I mean, if it does break and it doesn't do what I hope, then I'll probably go lean towards one of the other companies like Baker or OMP. Although I love the look of theirs as well, it looks like it's a limb, specifically limb holding vise, and I wanted something I could do a lot more with. So I've got my Prime Nexus 4 here. I'll be using all of this stuff for my Elite Ethos bow build when it comes. I just checked with Elite. They've got about 2 weeks left for it to be delivered. So this will come in and secure right on the handle. Just like that. And once you have that, you can work on it from here. Now I might raise it up a bit, but you can also just twist the knob, flip it around, and now you're set for tying in your nock sets, getting ready, putting on your D-loop. If you're adjusting your third axis on your sight, you've got a variety of different ways that you can flip this around. It also has the option to move this. You can go like this. So there's a lot of different angles you can hit with this. So if you put it up like this and then do one of these, there's a number of different ways that you can use this vise, which is pretty cool. Again, I don't know how long this is going to last, how well it's made. It looks pretty good with its all steel construction, but time will tell on the longevity of it all. So there's a little shelf. If you look in here, there's a little shelf that your handle can sit on as you wheel it in, tighten it down, and you've got, there we go. Now, so this is also, with all this different ways of adjusting, it's great that you can, you know, this table, as fine of a construction as it might be, some of these boards are a little wonky, so this is sitting slightly off of being level, but with all of the adjustment points, I'm still able to get it into a level position. The vise comes with four mounting bolts and a bottom bracket to go onto the bottom. It also comes with these levels. So it's got a string level. So you can see right now, just with a little couple of adjustments there and there, now that bow's perfectly level. And then it's got another level here, which you use for the arrows, which is pretty cool. So yeah, I'm pretty excited to get this going. I would like it, I think, a little bit higher. I mean, really here you're doing your some adjustments at this level, but most of it I would think is going to be when you're flipped around like this, which again you can also do in your Easy Green Last Chance Archery Press. But yeah, I'm pretty excited to get going with this thing and see what it has to do, how it has to offer. Right now it's working really great. It was $163 Canadian from Amazon. So if you're looking, if you're in the market for kind of a middle of the road price point vise, I mean, take a look at this one if you like. Again, I can't recommend, I haven't used it yet other than what you've just seen here. I haven't built anything on it, but it looks like it's gonna do pretty well. I mean, other than the internal components getting too stripped and you can't keep it tight, but I don't know how long that would take. And if you're only using it a couple times a year, a few times a year setting bows up, really once you've got everything set level, you don't really need the vise anymore, you just go to the press. So like I said, it's a 360 degree movement, up, down, left, right, you name it, it can do it. It's pretty incredible. Like I said you can secure it from the handle, or if you wanted, I guess if you wanted this to be a little higher, you could come up and grab the riser in here. That's another option. Or even down here, you could come in on an angle, secure it like that. I mean, this isn't really ideal, but if you want a little bit more height, you could secure it on the bottom of the riser like that. And then all you gotta do is adjust and flip it like that. Now, tire up, I can do more with it from here. This does look like it's gonna be a great vise for first, second, and third axis adjustment. Pretty happy with it so far. Hasn't caused many problems or broken on me, so that's good. And it might not. I might, you know, obviously things made in the US, made in Canada, you wanna really get behind and support. But really, if you're looking for something that's kind of the middle of the road, this could be an option for you. That's the Amaix bow vise, again, all steel construction. Looks like it's got a lot of versatility. You can hold the bow at a lot of different angles that are going to be very useful when setting it up. And it also comes with, like I said, these leveling pieces which are pretty cool. Other things that you may need in your shop when you're setting things up, I've got these Easton D-loop pliers. And if you're working on your D-loop, once you've tied your first knot, you can wrap the cord around this little hook here on the end and pull to stretch out your cord. Once you've got them both set up, you just open up the handle. These two pieces bite down together. You stick it in here, and then you're just gonna give pressure and tension on here to extend your D-loop to the size. Tighten up there. So that's pretty cool. D-loop material, of course, you're gonna want some of that. And I've got some BCY knocking point thread, which again is good for tying in your knock sets, but also securing your peep once you've got that set up. So if you like this video, hit like and subscribe, hit that notification bell for more videos like this. There's gonna be a lot more coming this year. We've got an Elite Ethos bow build coming. All the accessories will be explained and attached onto the new bow. A lot of hunts planned for this coming spring and fall, so stay tuned for that. And again, a lot more products that are going to be coming here that I'm going to be able to take out and use and report back how well they did out in the field. So again, if you like this video, hit like and subscribe, share them with your friends, and we'll see you on the next one.